friends, it's Mimi here today, and today I'm going to share with you my new What I Eat in a Day video. I really missed making these videos because I haven't done one in a while, so I'm super excited to share with you guys some of my new favorite recipes. Are you guys ready? Let's get started! So for breakfast today, I'm having some pure traditional rolled oats, and these are gluten-free. And also I'm gonna be using almond drink to make the oats, so basically to cook the oats. Sometimes I soak them overnight, but today I didn't, so I'm just gonna cook them. So first I pour some almond drink, and guys, I eyeball everything when I cook, but of course you can just follow the directions on the package. Usually there's more of the almond milk than the oats because I kind of like there to be more liquid. And then I cook everything for about 20 minutes, and I really like the texture because it's not too overcooked that way. So once I know it's ready, I'm just gonna serve it on a plate. And then usually I cut up some berries or a banana, whatever I have in the house that day, and try to make it nice and presentable. And if I have some dates, then I also add some dates on the side. And then I'm gonna drizzle everything with maple syrup. Yummy, yummy! Alright, time to enjoy the breakfast. Guys, it is so delicious and nutritious. I absolutely love this breakfast. It's very, very filling. And then Alexa woke up and she's like, "What are you guys doing there?" And it's so funny, whenever I'm eating something, she just comes and crawls to me and she wants to sit up on my knees and eat whatever it is that I'm eating. She really liked the oats too. All right, moving on to lunch. I'm gonna start with showing you how I make rice. I mean, there's many different ways to make rice, but this is how I make it, so I'm gonna show you. First, I start off with just rinsing the rice a few times and getting rid of that water. Also, I love adding cumin seeds to the rice. So whenever I make rice, I usually drizzle some olive oil on a pan and then I sprinkle some cumin seeds and I sort of fry that a little bit with sea salt. Then I would add my rice and fry that for about 2 minutes. Next, I'm gonna add some water. So obviously it's when you're cooking rice, it's 1 cup rice, 2 cups water. And here's my secret to getting rice that's not overcooked. I let the rice to boil for about 5 to 7 minutes before I let it simmer. Next, I'm gonna make vegetable stir fry. I'm gonna start with slicing some shallots really, really thinly. And then I'm gonna take a courgette, as they call it here in the UK, but it's the same thing as zucchini. So I'm gonna slice the zucchini nice and thin as well. Okay, while I'm slicing the veggies, I usually start frying the shallots on low medium heat. And then I'm gonna use a red pepper. So again, slicing everything really nice and thin. All right, now checking out my rice. It looks like it's ready. I'm gonna set that aside. And lastly, I'm gonna slice some shiitake mushrooms. I love mushrooms so much. If you like mushrooms, make sure to leave me a comment down below. All right, now I'm gonna add all the vegetables on a pan, and also I'm gonna add tamari sauce, which is sort of like soy sauce, but it's gluten-free. So I'm just gonna add that on top of everything. And this is also a substitute for salt in this dish. And then I'm gonna take 2 wooden spoons and sort of mix everything as I'm stir-frying it. So as I'm cooking the dish, I'm also mixing everything as I do it. All right, time to plate everything. It looks really, really pretty and colorful. I usually sprinkle some sesame seeds on top of this dish because it not only tastes delicious, it also looks really, really pretty. And the weather was really nice, so Alex and I decided to eat outside today. Mmm, so, so good, guys. This is definitely my new favorite dish. Love it. All right, for dinner today, I'm gonna be making something special. I'm gonna start with sweet potato fries. So first I peel the sweet potatoes and then I just slice them into nice strips. And the secret to these delicious sweet potato fries is the fresh rosemary. So I'm just gonna sprinkle everything with some rosemary. I also add sea salt and olive oil, and then I mix everything really, really nice, and I bake it for about 40 minutes at 250 Celsius, or it's about 480 Fahrenheit. While the sweet potatoes are baking, I'm gonna make this delicious mango salad. This has been my absolute favorite, and this is actually Layla's recipe. I'm not sure if she created it or if she got it somewhere, but she used to make the salad, and at first I wasn't really crazy about it, but now I love it. So what I'm gonna do is slice some peppers. I use green, yellow, and red, and I slice them really, really thinly. So that truly is the secret to this dish, is making it all delicate. Then take a cucumber, I peel the cucumber. I sort of peel it halfway, not fully, and then I also cut into thin strips. And then I'm gonna do the same thing with mango. So I use a couple of mangoes, sometimes one or two, depending how many I have. And then I also cut it nice and thin. There are sparks that fall right from on fire. And then I'm also gonna add some coriander, as we call it here, or cilantro, same thing. And then I'm gonna mix everything together. Look how pretty and colorful this looks. Okay, now I'm gonna be making the delicious dressing that is truly the secret to the salad. So I start with olive oil, then I add tamari sauce, then I'm gonna add some lime juice. So I'm gonna squeeze about one lime into this dressing. Also, I'm gonna be adding some ginger, so I'm gonna peel it, and then I'm gonna grate it on this really cool plate, which is sort of a ginger grater, but you could just use a garlic press to do the same. Can you feel how it goes? Then I mix everything and pour it over the salad. Also, I'm gonna be adding some cashews, and they are just delicious in the salad. So I'm gonna roast it on a pan until they're nice and golden. This white blanket, there is something they can't see. All right, salad is ready. So now I'm gonna make some prawns. I will peel some garlic and press it through garlic press. There are sparks that fall right. Then I'm gonna add some olive oil, some sea salt, and then I'm going to be adding my favorite seasoning of the moment, paprika. And I use smoked paprika, and then I use hot paprika. So I mix the two. And then mix everything together, and again, bake for about something like 15 minutes at 250 Celsius or 480 Fahrenheit. All right, guys, dinner is ready. And it's such a colorful plate. I'm so grateful to be having dinner and enjoying this with Alex. Here, I'm thanking him for helping me film this video, because it truly took a lot of work. And it took the whole day. So, Alex, thank you so much. All right, guys, if you want to see more What I Eat in a Day videos, let us know and we'll film more for you. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys so much. And like this video if you want to see more What I Eat in a Day videos. Bye. Under this white blanket, there is something they can't see. Mm.